Folks, Happy New Year. And now, and us to briefly go through Raila Amolo Odinga's 2023 message. You know, right now, politics is going to start. Like, that just the way Raila said, that it's now the beginning of the war to, of course, Canaan. Now, before I tell the message that Raila, of course, wrote today, I want to welcome you back to the channel. And I hope you're doing well, wherever you are. Welcome to the big question. And of course, if you're new here, take a time to subscribe so that we'll be meeting here every time. We have amazing political content. Now, today Raila gave out his message, and of course the president, William Samoei Ruto, went to Mombasa and he celebrated his Happy New Year in Mombasa. Like, he ushered in 2023 while in Mombasa. Now, I want us to quickly go through the last message, and of course, try and look at the impact it will have on Ruto's government. Now, I quote Raila Odinga's message: "We have come to the end of 2022. We thank God that we are able to usher in 2023 in celebrations. As we celebrate, it is also incumbent the nation to recalibrate. Yeah, for one, we have had a difficult 2022 with hotly contested elections." Now, you see, Raila Odinga is admitting the fact that 2022 was a hotly contested elections, whereby the winner did not leave the second the huge gap. Yeah, it was just around 200,000 votes. Let me go on in the message. "Living conditions were made more trying by the difficult economic circumstances that prevailed and continued as we usher in the new year." Yeah, he's saying that the living conditions, Kenyans are now suffering. Like, people hardly put food on the table, which is a reality. Everything is high, like unga price is high, it has never dropped, despite the fact that William Ruto promised Kenyans that he would lower the price of unga. Fuel is set to rise in January. So, of course, Kenyans are set to go through a lot of problems. I think this needs to stop because it's not good. Like, we are suffering. That's the reality. People are suffering. Especially people on the low-income earners. Right now, when you go to stage here in Nairobi, you find that so many people are going to Mashambani, to Ocha, the third to Ocha. Because, you know, you have a family. Maybe your income is low, you can't, you know, sustain yourself with your family. So how will you remain in Nairobi? You hope to go to Ocha. Now, let me continue with Raila's message. "I am, however, bored and looking forward to a better year and better times in 2023. Yeah, he's saying that in 2023 things will be better because he will fight for Kenyans. And it'll make sure that everyone gets what he or she deserves, which is good. Now, right now, he's the opposition leader. So his work is, of course, to make sure that people are not suffering. The government, of course, has failed Kenyans. Yeah, despite it being young. You know, the promise, you know, when you promise someone something, you need to do what you promised him. Don't promise heaven when now you deliver hell. Because Ruto said that the first week, unga will go down and blah, blah, blah. But nothing like that has happened. The ASLA fund, people are blaming the ASLA fund because the maximum can be given is maybe 700 shillings or maybe 500. So what will you do with 500? Nothing. Cannot do any business with 500. That's the reality. So that's the last message. And of course, this prompted, okay, Ruto went to Mombasa. And of course, I also liked his message because he said that he'll serve Kenyans equally. And of course, people who are in the position are seeing the government, which is true. So I think it's upon him to make sure that life is bearable in Kenya, because right now people are suffering. They are like, 2023, think something needs to be done in 2023, else people will lose it. Because something needs to be done in 2023. That's the reality. So folks, that's the last message. Yeah, he's saying that he will fight for Kenyans. And of course, remember he said that in January, this month he will tell Kenyans, his supporters, his next political move. So of course people are eagerly waiting to see or to hear what Raila will say this month. So with only that's the message. Subscribe, of course. I also tell you Ruto's message in the next video. Thank you. See you soon.